That's what Saxon Walk feel like. I mean, all those houses, those gardens, that cool sprinkling water. It was insanity. Well, I got on the bus and sat next to a bunch of domestic servants and gardeners and listened to their chat about what the bosses and the manners were eating and paying and wearing. And this is what they saw and said and did every day. Got off at the right stop up Oxford Road, near a convent school. Mia's house wasn't as big as everyone else's, but the garden was beautiful.
My brother-in-law, Morris Steiner, is here from Australia, and he's staying with me. Nothing he has seen or has heard has affected him as much as seeing little Dumasani laying there in my spare room. He says to me, "Come to Sydney, Mammy. How can you handle it here?" And I said to him, "What the hell are you talking about? I don't want to go. What do you want me to do? Leave because of all the fuck-ups these pricks have made here?" Yeah. We both burst out laughing. But as Mike used to say, it was a very black, a very Jewish sound.
Mia answered the door herself.
Zach, I'm sorry. I tried to phone you. He's under heavy sedation. I don't know when
he'll get out. Can I see?
Yes, this way.
Tiptoe down the passageway. He opened the door. Dumasani was laying in a big double bed. His head swollen, his eyes shut. Everything around him was little blue flowers. I mean, the wallpaper, the curtains, the pillow on his head. He started to move. Here, quickly close the door.
Zach, I'm sorry. Can I get you tea or something?
Oh, I must go. I just
wanted to pick him up.
Carry him home. Walk back toward the bus stop, still holding his baseball bat. As I got to the convent school, I was still thinking about Dumasani. There were little white girls and their little white clean uniforms having their morning break. So I watched them. I watched them laughing and running and playing. I thought, yeah, every one of you has a nanny. I mean, she feeds you, she comforts you, she washes that uniform, she polishes those shoes. And every time she leaves Alexander or Soweto and says goodbye to her own children, she doesn't know that she'll see them again, alive or dead. Yeah. And Nanny knows where the kitchen knives are. She even knows where your daddy hides the revolver. Your mommy's Nanny knew too. But how many of you do they kill? Ask her about our children and the soldiers who shoot them dead. Ask her what she's waiting for. Huh? For the fool that we can kill as long as they can. I found myself moving to the middle of the playground and I started swinging. Left and right, skull scratch, brains and baby teeth blue, there was blood everywhere, legs and arms minutes, I was a panda, I was a tiger, I was everything they wanted me to be, I was a black King Kong! I found myself still on the pavement. So I got up. I continued to watch them. I walked back toward Oxford Road and couldn't breathe. I heard myself yelling. Fuck you! Fuck you! What have you done to Dumasani? Fuck you for what you are doing to me!
I was so excited. So many of them were